just a little bit so you can kind of see a little better. And you let me know if you can't. We'll fix that for you. See if I can't bring it in a little more to you. Okay. Get set up over here real quick. Hope everybody is having a great Thursday. Looks like we might be in for some storms here in just a little bit, but other than that, it hasn't been too bad. And I think it's supposed to get a little cooler. Which I don't think we want, but my video. Hang on here. I'm sorry about that. Hit the wrong button. Okay, let's go ahead and get started, because as y'all know, sometimes my internet is not the best. And if we are in for some storms, that could affect it a little bit. So right now what I'm doing is I am putting in the filler boxwood that we started yesterday. And I'm just going around. Turn that down. I don't need to hear myself. Going around and putting these in to kind of give it a little feel. I love it because these have little yellow flowers on them, or buds that coordinate with the big yellow flowers and the yellow in the berries. Had some people ask me about little vases that you can place on each side of a monument, and if we get done in time, I will maybe do one of those real quick. Said right now I'm filling in. Let me know if you can see this real well. If not, I'll adjust things a little. When you push these to the end of the stem, just be real careful you don't forget your own strength and push them right off the edge. And if you do, that's okay. I've reattached them and used them. Weather like today at your house? Like I said, it looks like we could get some storms again. We had some early this morning. course, we've had the wind. What would spring be like without the wind? Has anyone on here made any of these headstone saddles before, or any type of cemetery arrangement? I've made a few. It's not difficult to do. Kind of turn this a little bit. See, I've got a hole right there I need to fill. We'll be adding some more things here in just a second. Can you see that okay? Maybe pull that out just a little bit. Rather have you seeing the saddle than my face. Okay. Yeah, I had, like I said earlier, I was kind of playing around while I was waiting to come live on here. I have went ahead and put in another flower here and some little white ones here. I'm gonna go around on the other side and we're gonna do the same thing there. Grab a flower. Glue, and I'm just going to stick that in, then I have some little white flowers with the berries. They're kind of cute. I'm just going to go on each side of that, push that into the styrofoam. Other side, push it in. Now if you're going to make these at home, you know, make sure you get quite a bit of glue on your ends of your flowers to hold them into that styrofoam and push them as far as you can in the styrofoam, but still where the flowers are showing. Okay, let's see. I think we'll put, this one may have to have a pick on it. I think it will. Sometimes I get ahead of myself and cut them a little too short. So we just add a pick to it. Some blue. Hello, Kathy. Hi, Barb. Thank you, Barb. Oh, that's a neat idea, Kathy. That was a very neat idea. we're going to take a yellow one and put out here on the end. Make it, see, I gotta get around here where I can see if I'm at halfway in the middle there. Just, I don't know why that crazy thing doesn't, wait a minute. I don't know why that one doesn't have a leaf on the end of it. We can remedy that too, I think. I think I have one. Had that happen before. I was clipping and I looked up and my camera's telling me that it didn't like the clipping. I don't think I've ever had that happen before. Try this again here. Careful when you're using the glue, because that stuff can get pretty nasty sometimes and burn. Okay, let me just take a look at this. You can look at it with me also, just to see. It out. That's what I remember. I'm always saying that you, if you need to, pull them out, just pull them out gently. Well, for some reason, it's not wanting to go where I want it to go. There we go. Okay, now I have some. These are just little, I'm not sure what you call them, ivy, but they have kind of a frosted look to them, smooth, almost like a lamb's ear type smooth to them. And I'm just going to insert a few of those around. Open here beside my table. It feels so good, the wind coming through. I'm really not looking forward to hot weather. I'm not a hot weather person. Yeah, I don't think I like that. So we're going to take that one out and put in a smaller one. It was just a little too long for me. few and stick them in. It doesn't have to be all over. Hi, Cindy. Thank you. Off a few more of those. You know me, I have to keep putting things in. Kind of take a look at that. There I am a little. Hi, Jan. Okay. Are you guys seeing this all right? Things just get up and walk away. There it is. These are just some little fronds, leafy things, kind of like a spike. So I'm going to take those and I'm going to just put those down in the top. Each side of the flower on top. And I think that's it. What do you think? You guys see it all the way around? And you can kind of play with it and adjust the flowers and what the finished look is. That'd be pretty over a headstone. And I'm going to show you, I keep picking off the glue here. I'm going to show you. I won't turn it on because I don't think you'll be able to hear me if I do. But I have this, it's a heat gun. And I just plugged in. Like I said, I don't know. It could get kind of loud, but we'll try. And I just set it around 550, and you got to be really careful that if you just kind of go along the edges, it'll melt that wax down, the glue down. But like I said, you got to be really careful because if you have plastic, it will melt the plastic. But it just really takes that glue off. And if you're doing anything with Deco mesh, it will definitely melt the mesh. That's from experience. But that gets some of those strings off. That is a crafter's nightmare. Guess it's not real loud. Hi Teresa, you have your little people down for naps? Well, there's where it gets loud because it has to cool down. Set it back here, it won't take long. But anyway, you can buy one of those at Harbor Freight, hardware stores. I think you might even be able to buy them at Hobby Lobby. I don't know for sure, but I took that one out of my husband's workshop. So that's, and I'm sure he probably got it at Menards or Harbor Freight, but it works wonders. It really helps get those glue strings off. Like I said, that's a crafter's nightmare. So okay, we have this finished. Can everybody see that? I'll post a picture of it too when we're done. So turning it, you can see it. Okay, now I'm going to set this aside because I have had a lady inquire about the vases that go, move that out of my little bit, that can go on each side of a headstone. Now I buy these, I think I bought this maybe, I don't know, I think I bought it through Amazon a few years ago, and they come in two sets, and then what I do is you can go to Hobby Lobby or any floral place and buy the cone-shaped styrofoam. And I just turn that over and put that in. But before I do that, you can take your glue gun or skillet, whichever you may have, and I just put a bunch of glue around it. I guess I won't because that one's not turned on. But I'm just going to take my, put it down in my glue skillet here and get a good thing of glue on it. And push it down into the cone, just like so. I don't know if you can see that or not. I guess I better go this way now. And then when you're all done, it comes with a stake that goes on the bottom. You just twist it on the bottom. And I picked out some, I thought I might just do one with the yellow flowers, but I don't know if I have enough or not. And you just push them in. I'm just grabbing a few things I have here. And around. I don't think I have a whole lot of stuff over here. I'll tell you what. Let's just do this. I have some flowers back here that I was going to use for another thing. We'll just do it. Aren't these pretty? These are pretty also. One in a purple. And again, I'm going to put picks on the ends of these. Putting them in. Some moss in there. Just take your moss and put it down through there because your glue is going to help stick as you're putting in your flower stems. Super quiet today. Keep in mind, this is a quick little tutorial here. But it's fairly easy to do these. too full. Some more glue. Let's see what else I've got laying around here. I'm sure I have something. It's also a good way to use up your flowers, your leftover flowers. Oh, don't like that. Put that over here. And I've just kind of made this kind of like a triangle. But you can, again, you can make this however you want. You can make it all flowers. I just randomly kind of put in some things that I had laying here that we didn't use earlier. Wish I had one more of those. That's okay. We'll put something else there. I know. Put a fern frond. Did you hear me say ouch? Hurt my finger. Time to work on my machine again. Anybody on here has anyone going to prom next week? My oldest granddaughter, it's her last prom. She made her corsage and her escort's boutonniere last year, so she's going to do it again this year. And one of her friends is going to come also and make hers. But part of it will be soap flowers, but they like to use live flowers. And so Grandma gets to go pick up roses and orchids next week and be prepared to do live flowers. usually what I do is I just sit back and let her do them. She's pretty good at what she does with them. She's got a good eye for arranging. So, okay, I'm just going to stop because I'm just kind of randomly sticking things in. But this is basically what it would look like. I'm going to turn it a little bit so you can see down there. And then, like I said, you just take this and put it, if you're wanting to put it in the ground, you just pop that in, stick it in the ground. Or if you just want to set it on, some headstones have little side lips on them, and some families like to set them on that. If you do that, the one thing I do suggest doing is filling the bottom of the vase with some rocks or something so that it won't tip over or blow over. Okay? I hope you've enjoyed watching me make these today. And like I said, I just kind of randomly put some stuff in, but I think it turned out pretty. I like purple. And so, like I said, I just hope you enjoyed watching the video. And maybe if you make one, put it on here and show us. We'd love to see you, see what you make. Okay? I hope everybody has a good Thursday afternoon, and stay dry and stay safe. Bye.